Welcome to Hoshizaki Technical Training. I'm David Bowen, here to talk to you today about sequence of operation on the KM ice machines. Today we're going to be talking to you about a KM520 self-contained air-cooled machine. And to get this machine started, you need to make sure your mode switch is in ice position and your control switch is in the on position to get the unit started in the field cycle. With the unit on in ice mode, the first thing that happens, the board energizes, power LED comes on. After a short 15-second delay, the water valve LED comes on and sending power to the water fill valve. The water fill valve sends water over through the top side of the evaporator, running down through the evaporator to fill the reservoir. After 1 minute, the board checks to see if the float switch is closed. The float switch is located inside the water tank. After 1 minute, the float switch is closed. It starts a harvest cycle. If it does not close within 1 minute, it just continues to fill until the float switch does close to begin your harvest cycle. Once the float switch is closed, we're ready to begin the harvest cycle. The harvest cycle is when we're trying to remove ice from the evaporator plate. On this startup, there's no ice on the plate, but we still do the same sequence every single time. So we're ready to start harvest. We bring on the compressor and the hot gas valve comes on. If you have a remote condensing unit, that fan motor will run with the compressor. So we start producing hot discharge gas through the top side of the evaporator and runs through the evaporator and out the suction line. We also leave our water fill valve on. The water fill valve is used as a harvest assist, pushing water down through the inside of the evaporator. In harvest cycle, the board is looking for the thermistor that's taking the temperature of our suction line. A suction line reaches 48 degrees. The board sees a 3.9 kOhm signal from the thermistor. Then it starts a timer. The timer is adjustable on the board between 1 and 3 minutes. Dip switches 1 and 2 on your board. So the board knows when the last 50 seconds are coming around on the harvest cycle. So at that last 50 seconds, it brings on the water pump, turns the water fill valve off. This pushes water down the outside of the evaporator plate to knock off any ice that may be remaining that didn't fall in the normal harvest cycle. As long as the float switch is closed, it will begin a free cycle. If the float switch is open, it goes back, cuts the compressor off, goes back to water fill only. After harvest cycle, we start our freeze cycle. The compressor stays on, and to begin freeze, we got to cut the hot gas valve off and also bring on the fan motor. Remote fan motor stays on. If you have a liquid line solenoid on remote systems, it energizes, allowing liquid refrigerant to pass through the expansion valve into the top side of the evaporator. The frost was happening on the first line into the evaporator, chilling the plate down, pulling the heat out of the water, forming ice on the plate. As water level drops, because it's being formed into ice, the water level drops, the float switch opens, and that terminates the freeze cycle. Once you begin a freeze cycle, you have a 5-minute window that it will not look at the float switch for the first 5 minutes. Anytime after 5 minutes, it will terminate your freeze cycle. After the freeze cycle ends, meaning the float switch is open, say we don't have much water left in the tank, the pump out cycle can begin. Once every 10 cycles, it would go to a default pump out. Other than that, it goes straight back to harvest. After 10 freeze cycles, the unit will enter a pump out cycle. So at that point, the self-contained air cooled fan cuts off, liquid line solenoid turns off. If you got a remote fan motor, it stays on, the compressor stays on, and the pump motor will stop for 2 seconds and then re-energize with a open drain solenoid valve. It gets rid of all the water out of the water tank to get rid of mineral buildup after a freeze cycle. After pump out is complete, the unit will enter a harvest cycle. The unit will run in freeze and harvest, dropping ice in harvest. As the ice fills up into the ice storage bin, it reaches the level where the bin control is set. When the bend control sees the ice level is enough, then it will enter a shutdown. And what it'll do is it'll shut down at the end of harvest. So at any time during harvest, the bend control sees the ice level is reaching the point of full bend. It will not shut the machine down until the end of harvest. It'll let it complete that harvest cycle and then shut down. Once the ice is used, then the level drops enough to deactivate the bend control switch and the unit just restarts in the field cycle. Thanks for watching today on Hoshizaki Technical Training on the KM Sequence of Operation. If you need further assistance, please contact technical support or check out our service manuals for any further information.